Hi, my name is Sajanya Konkimalla and my teammates are Rohita and Ramya. Our project is about building buildings in a more energy efficient way. There is an increase in energy consumption all over the world which increases the cost of the energy, and this has been a burden on the people. So people need to use more technologies and renewable resources in order to reduce the consumption of energy. The goal of this project is to find building characteristics and associated technologies which help in conservation of the energy. So the objective of our model is to minimize the consumption of energy on the buildings by using new energy efficient techniques which consume 35% more energy than the ordinary buildings. So the agenda of our project is project goals, data preparation, model building, model assessment, original versus final conclusions, assumptions and conclusion. The project, let's start with the project goals. The project goals are correlating various parameters of the buildings to its energy consumption. We have so many parameters of the buildings and we have considered all these parameters in our project to reduce the energy consumption. And these parameters help in building our models by implementing them as target variables and independent variables. And we have divided the entire data into efficient and non-efficient based on the performance. Like sometimes buildings use more energy which has a different building shape which has different shape than the other building. So building shape is also also affects the performance of the energy. We have created predictive models which can identify the building such as non efficient or non efficient, and in this to create these predictive models we use the above mentioned parameters as target and independent variable. We have suggested ways to improve efficiency of the buildings. Data preparation is the most important step because in order to create a very good model, we have to spend as much as time on the preparation of the data by removing all the extra characters or outliers we don't want or missing data, all etc. The steps involved in data preparation are data access, consolidation, cleaning, transformation and reduction. We have taken the data files from the public use data repository of Energy Information Administration website. This data is collected by the government of USA and published so that it can be used by the public in finding out different measures such as us finding out the project. The data has been put together and provided to the public. And we have chosen this data because of its consistency and reliability. There are basically 19 files collected from 5,215 buildings from 50 states all over the world. Let's talk about data consolidation. These 19 files have abundant information, so the variables are selected as per the goals or our goals and requirements. The models we need to create contains different target variables. So we have taken these parameters based on the necessity of our goal, and we used IBM SPSS modeler merge in order to consolidate an entire file and then create models rather than constructing model on very single file and then mixing it up. Data cleaning. Our data contains building information from malls, schools and commercial and non-commercial such as malls and schools, and we have lot of missing data in malls, so we imputed the missing values as others and we remove the outliers for a better model and better analysis. The rest of the data preparation is explained by my teammate Rohita. Thank you.
Thank you, Sajanya. So the next part of data preparation step is data transformation, and for our analysis, the first transformation that we did was we calculated the subtotal of energy consumption from all of the individual energy devices, energy sources basically. So the consumption due to electricity was combined with the consumption due to natural gas and so on. And we then created a consolidated column which calculated the total energy consumption. Then we also derived a new column called the efficiency metric. This efficiency metric is basically a performance metric for each building, so that each building can be evaluated in the same standard way. Basically, the total energy consumed for a building may vary for the different sizes of the building. Like if the building has more number of floors and if the building area is lesser and the building that is operational for a longer time as compared to the other building. So so we want to standardize that and put every building to the same scale. We created this column. The formula for this efficiency metric is the total energy consumed by the building divided by the square foot area of the building, number of floors in that building, and also divided by the operational hours of the building in a week. Once this new efficiency metric column is created, we create a flat variable to make the distinction between the efficient buildings and non-efficient buildings, which will be discussed later. Data reduction. We only kept those buildings that are using electricity and natural gas, and we removed the rest of the buildings. Like for our initial, for this study, we are concentrating only on the buildings which are using electricity and natural gas, which covers up to be almost the 70% of the buildings. 70% of the records. So we kept those buildings and then we also found that few buildings, the weekly operating hour were shown as zero. That means that either the record is, it's not correctly recorded, or it could also be that the building is not operational at all. So it is abandoned. So we thought of removing those records, and we removed those records, and that is our another process of data reduction. So after all the data, preparation step, we are left with this data dictionary. We have the building unique identifier, the area of the building, the year it was constructed, the material used to construct the wall, then the building shape, the type of heating equipment used, the type of cooling equipment used, efficiency metric, and the flag variable for the efficiency metric. Moving on to the model building step. This is one of the most crucial steps for our analysis. After having completed the data preparation, now our next consideration is how do we choose the target variable? Basically, our project scope is to suggest efficiency criteria for buildings which we are renovating, and also to suggest efficiency criteria for the building which we are constructing newly. So for them, the target variable have to be different, or they could be the same. But the parameters have to be different for the old building and the new building. Then we have the descriptive statistics, the model selection, then we generate the test design, and we also build models. Using the target variable, we created the key metric which will measure each building performance. And based on that metric, we found the top 25% of the building, we kept them as the most efficient buildings. The top 25% of the values which are lesser are the most efficient values, and mark them as 1, and the rest of the 75% we mark them as 0, and they are basically our non-efficient buildings, and they are the buildings for which we will suggest efficiency criteria. As we can see, the average of the non-efficient buildings is 1486 and the total average is 467, and we can see there is a clear distinction between the non-efficient buildings and the average of the total buildings. And also there's a clear distinction between the average of the efficient buildings and the total average of the building. So top 25 percentile is the rule that we have kept to create our flag variable of efficient building and non-efficient buildings. The next part of the presentation will be taken by Ramya.
Thank you, Rohita, and I'm Ramya. I would like to continue with the descriptive statistics. We have performed descriptive analysis using the Tableau software. The first graph shown here is between the main heating equipment and the average electricity used and the average natural gas used. This graph basically tells us the performance of the equipment. For better performance, the energy consumption has to be low. While observing the graph, it can be seen that the district steam or hot water performs better when used with natural gas rather than the electricity. Similarly, the boilers inside the building has performed better when used with electricity rather than the natural gas. Similarly with the other equipments. And the same analysis is done for the main cooling equipment as well. And the chart below here is for the performance of the heating equipment with the number of floors. By looking at the chart, it can be seen that for the buildings with 0 to 14 floors, individual space heaters has better performance. Similarly, for the buildings with over 25 floors, heat pumps for heating has a better performance. By this analysis, it can be suggested what heating equipment can be provided for the number of floors. Similar analysis is provided for the main cooling equipment as well. The adjoining chart here is with the wall construction material and the glass area. This chart depicts as what glass area can be provided for the wall construction material for a low energy consumption. By observing the graph, it can be told that for brick, stone or stucco type of wall construction material, less glass area would give us low energy consumption when natural gas is used, and more glass area is preferable when electricity is used. Similarly, for decorative or construction glass type wall construction material, the less glass area is preferable for the more glass area is preferable for electricity as well as natural gas, as well as energy consumption is used. Similar analysis are performed for various combinations of parameters to suggest which one provides better performance with what kind of statistics. Selection of motives. Basically, the business statement that we are focusing on are the prediction of whether the buildings are energy efficient or not. If the building turns out to be non-efficient, then we are predicting the parameters as well, like the values for the parameters such that the building turns out to be more efficient. For this kind of project, basically we need predictive models. Therefore, the predictive models suitable for this project are logistic regression, neural networks, and C5.0 decision tree. The models are built separately for the construction of new buildings as well as for the renovation of old buildings. We have did separate models since the parameters to predict whether the building are efficient or not are different for the new buildings as well as old buildings. For example, if old building turned out to be non-efficient, then the parameters which can change to that building are heating equipment, cooling equipment, wall construction area. So these parameters can be changed for the old buildings to make it to be an energy efficient. Whereas for the new buildings, the parameters that we can change apart from main cooling equipment, main heating equipment, wall construction area, is the building shape and the number of floors, operating hours, etc. Since the new buildings, the construction has not yet started, and we can make changes in the building shape or the number of floors for the building to prove out to be energy efficient. So for that case, we have the separate models for new construction buildings and also for the old buildings. Generation of test design. Our data, we divided it into three data sets: training data set, testing data set, and validation data set. For this, we have used IBM SPSS Modelers partition node. Initially, our data, the entire data, we have used with a partition node, and we have divided it into training and testing with a percentage of 80 and 20. And then we have exported that to the Excel sheet, and using the partition variable created by the software, we have separated into the training data set and the testing data set. And that separated training data set is again used as an input to the partition node, and we have divided it into the training data set and validation data set again with that 80 to 20%. By this, we exported to the Excel sheet and again separated training and validation. By this, we obtained three data sets: training, testing, and validation, with a percentage of 64, 20, and 16 respectively. By this kind of we can have a hold, we can have the handle on the model, so that it gives us without any overestimation or overprediction or overfitting of the model. Process to develop models. We have used IBM SPSS modeler to develop our models. We have used inputs as a training, testing, and validation data sets, and we have used filters to filter the parameters according to the new buildings or the old buildings. And then for this filter, we have given the node. This is the logistic regression model. However, for neural networks, we use the neural network node, and for C50. Model we use the C5.0 decision tree node, and when the model is run, we'll get an output, and we have used an analysis tool for further examining the output. And well, after analyzing the model using the training, then the testing is given as input to the filter, and after the analysis is done, we are giving the validation. In such a way, the model is built for the new building and old building for each of the models: logistic, regression, neural networks, and C5.0 decision tree. Logistic regression. Logistic regression model generally allows us to predict the target variable based on the independent variables. And after executing the node, the predictor importance output, which was given, which was generated, shows that the number of hours is operated per week as the most important variable for the energy consumption, and followed by mean heating equipment, number of floors, building shape, mean cooling equipment, glass area, and with the least important as wall construction material. And for this model, the accuracy turns out to be 76.5% with a precision of 93.9%, and the true positive rate turns out to be 78.7%, and the true negative rate as 59.2%. And with the logistic regression model, we got the logistic regression equation, which was very important for us to predict whether the building was energy efficient or not. And after this, we can even adjust the parameters values accordingly to make the building energy efficient. For example, this is a logistic regression equation for the new building construction. Here we have 0.02194, which is the coefficient for the number of weeks operated per number of hours operated per week, followed by the main heating equipment's coefficient for boilers inside the building, and this is the coefficient for the main heating equipment for district steam or hot water, and similarly, this is the coefficient for main cooling equipment for central chillers inside the building, and so on. For suppose if the new building turns out to be not energy efficient, so we'll try to predict the these parameters so that the output would come as the energy efficient building. Suppose if we want to adjust the number of hours, so that we put that value here and then multiply with the square efficient, keeping all the other parameters constant, then we'll be getting the output whether the building is energy efficient or not. Similarly, if we want to use boilers inside the building so that the building would become energy efficient with that, so we put out 1, so we would multiply the equation with this coefficient, putting a 0 for all the other main heating equipment, putting all the other parameters constant, we can now get the target variable, and we'll be adjusting the parameters, so on and so forth, so that the output target variable, which is energy efficient, tells us whether the building is energy efficient or not. So we'll be adjusting this to turn the building to be energy. Then this is for the old building renovation. This is the equation which we use, and the similar explanation goes for this equation as well. 0.02251 is the coefficient for the number of hours operating per week. And similarly for the heating equipment with boilers inside the building and the heating equipment with furnaces, these are the respective coefficients. So by adjusting these parameters, we can suggest the old buildings which are not efficient to turn out to be efficient by using those values for those parameters. The second model which we have built for the project was for our data set is neural network. The neural network will tell us the dependence of the target variable on the dependence of the target variables on the dependent variable. After executing the mode, predictor importance for the target variable due to flag or the energy efficient flag was the number of hours operated per week turned out to be the most important, followed by maintenance. And the least turned out to be the glass area. And for the neural network, it turned out to be that the accuracy is 88.29% for the new buildings, and for the old building it turned out to be 78.69%. And by using the coincidence matrix, we can calculate the precision, true positive rate, true negative rate. And for the new building, the true positive rate turned out to be 90.90%. Old building, the coincidence matrix, the true positive rate and true negative rate can be calculated. By looking into this, we can see that neural network has a high accuracy. And 5.0 efficiency by using the 5.0 node in the IPL SPSS modeler, we have connected that to the filter as explained. And the predictor importance turn out to be that the number of hours operated per week as the most important variable. So most of the models that was given as the most important variable formed by building shape, glass area, vehicle area. This is for the new building. And we can see that a few of the parameters were not shown up here. This is because they were not able to enter the model in the stepwise selection which the model has operated. This is a disadvantage for this model. But however, this was very important for the project for prediction phase. And we have the 5.0 decision tree, which is the output for the number of hours operated for weeks less than or equal to 150. We have less than 45, less than or equal to 45, and then less than or equal to 30, and then 35. For that, we have the mean and median. So this is like the tree which is going on, and what can be used to predict based on that. So this is how we build the models, and how we executed the models, and this is how drawn the output from this model, and their assessment of these models and how they are used for the business question and how they answer that business question next explained by Rohita. Thank you.
Thank you, Ramya. Moving ahead, now we'll deal with the model assessment. We'll assess the model based on the objective analysis, we'll do the subjective assessment, we'll also discuss the strengths and weaknesses of each models, and also finally we'll select best model for our study. Coming to the objective assessment, this chart sums up the accuracy and precision returns from each of the models after running the models, and we can clearly see the comparison between each models. We have the, as we can see, accuracy wise, all of the models are very much similar in their behavior, and precision wise, for the old buildings, the C5 decision trees network actually gives us a better result than others. However, the difference between the precision amongst the models is still comparable. So this is the objective assessment, and we see that overall the neural network gives the best performance for the new buildings, while the C5.0 gives the best performance in old buildings. But that should not be our only concern while selecting the best model and the final end product. So we then further moving ahead to the subjective assessment, we find that the logistic regression equation that we get from the logistic regression would fulfill the goal of the project. And since there was not much difference between the accuracy and precision of between the models of logistic regression and the other select better models, so logistic regression can be chosen as the project. Basically, the regression equation helps us in a lot of ways. Once we predict that this certain building is not efficient, we can go back to the regression equation, and depending on by what amount it lacks being perfect efficient building, we can calculate that and we can assess which factor will help us best. Firstly, we'll start with the factor which has the highest value of predictor importance. We'll change the value for that. We'll suggest the constructor that is it possible for you to change the wall construction material from this to this so that your efficiency metric will actually improve from this value to decrease to this value. So that's how logistic regression equation comes in handy while predicting the, or better to say, suggesting the better means to make the building energy efficient. So basically the parameter values in the logistic regression equation will come in handy while giving suggestions regarding to make the inefficient buildings into efficient buildings. Strength of weaknesses of each models. The logistic regression model, the equation can be easily interpreted to our benefit. Well, it has a little less accuracy, that's one of its weaknesses as compared to the network. Coming to neural network, it gave us pretty good numbers, we have good accuracy for that model. However, it is difficult to interpret the network to our benefit, so that's a big weakness on neural network. Then the third model is the C5.0 decision tree. Strength is it is limited to few parameters, so it's a good thing that we can tweak only few parameters to get our end product, and the weakness is low accuracy. So the best model as per our convenience of our business problem appears to be the logistic regression model, so the logistic regression model is the winner for our project. Original vision versus final product. Well, when we began our project, we were just hoping to classify the different buildings into different categories, basically inefficient and efficient based on their energy consumption. But as we move ahead, as we move forward, we extended the project scope to predict values using the parameter values and using them to our benefit, and how we can suggest the builder or the renovator to make their building more efficient by what changes they can bring in some parameters. So also we had that initial assumption that the neural network has been performing the best, but while explaining the model to our benefit, it could not prove as much beneficial as we were expecting it to be. So because there was not much of a difference between the logistic regression and neural network accuracy, we could easily rule out the use of neural network model. So to conclude the presentation, well, this was quite a bit of learning experience, and the first experience I would like to mention is the importance of data preparation. Because once we are done with all the five steps of data preparation, there comes a stage when we think that yes, this is the farthest that we can do, and then we start building the models, and then the model does not give us accurate results and does not give us consistent results. So that's when we think that maybe we'll have to make some changes, make the parameters less categorized, and that kind of data preparation steps, we had to go back and forth from each step, and that's how important the data preparation is. Choosing the target variable, like we did not have any specific metric given to us from the data set, so we had to create our own metric, because we could not just classify the building as efficient or non-efficient depending on the energy consumption, because few buildings because they are huge in size. That is why they are using more energy. But that's why we had to standardize all the buildings, and that's we created this target variable, we created target flag for the predictive model, and that's how we got to know the importance of choosing a target variable. Selection building of models. As we went ahead with the models and as we started learning about one model, we just could not rule out the other models. We had to look through each and every models and how their performance is and how we can use the parameters given from the models to our benefits. So we had a lot of fun experimenting with all the different models we were given in our tool. And assessment of models. It was quite a tricky part because the numbers they came out almost similar for each of the buildings and for each of the models, I'm sorry. And we could not just assess the models based on their numbers that were showing up. We had to keep our subjective preferences in our mind while selecting the best model, and that's how we came up with the logistic regression model. Thank you so much for your patient listening. Team Energy will like to answer any questions you have. You could email us. Thank you so much.